Welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding assent by default written by Vidya Subramaniam. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2 and paper 4. Plus this is important for political science and public administration and sociology optional students. Now in this editorial I will be discussing three things. First of all, I will be discussing about why this assent that the author has talked about, why this assent has taken place. And second thing is about why default is in existence. And the third thing is how to reverse this assent. And is it good for India or is it bad for Indian polity? Now, before we discuss about why this assent has taken place, it is important to understand what is meant by assent in this editorial and what is meant by default. Now, assent means the stupendous, the phenomenal rise, the burgeoning rise of the BJP that it has seen after 2014 Lok Sabha elections. And why this assent, why this rise, why this inertia of win is sustaining for such a long time, and why this assent is being predicted again in Uttar Pradesh. It is being predicted because of the defaultness, assent by default. Now, by default here means that there exists a vacuum, there exists a lack of opponents, there exists a lack of competition, there exists a lack of no one existing to challenge you. So the BJP, it has become a kind of a party which is not having any kind of phenomenal challenge in Uttar Pradesh in existence. Now why this thing, why this phenomena has occurred, and what are the factors behind this phenomena? Now why this assent? This assent, because in order to understand this assent, we need to understand the polity of India. We need to understand the nature of an Indian. An Indian is more concerned about self-identity. So Indian politics, Indian election system, it actually hovers around this identity thing. Now, as far as this identity is concerned, there are multiple identities which a normal citizen actually relates himself or herself to. Now, what are these identities? The identity based on religion. This is one big identity in India. If you will not convey your religion to the other, the people will not be ready to talk to you. The people will not be ready to assimilate you in their group, in their social circle. So this is a very big identity. Second kind of identity is the identity of caste. And the third kind of identity is the identity of region. Then another kind of identity is the identity of language. Then other kind of identity is the identity of a class, whether you're rich or you're poor. So these multiple identities in India, when they mix together, when they churn together, they make a person an Indian. That is something that is what a true Indian is. A true Indian is very much concerned about all these things. So the assent of the BJP relates to manipulating, it relates to maneuvering, it relates to caricaturing, it relates to secreting this identity of an Indian. Now, BJP has been able to understand the political landscape of India, and on the basis of that they have developed an ideology. What is that ideology? That ideology is the ideology of majoritarianism. Now, what is this majoritarianism? Now, this majoritarianism means BJP is playing its cards in such a way so that a majority stands with them. And what card they are playing? They are playing the card of Hindi, Hindu and Hindustan. This is a potent card that they are holding in their hands. Now, this card, it had lost its relevancy after 1990. After 1990, the fruits, the winds of this globalization, liberalization and privatization had begin to flow and blow. And these winds, this change had altered the psyche of the people to some extent. And the people had begin to feel more and more associated with the modernization, with the modernity. But after 2008, there was an economic crisis, and that economic crisis had put the nation back in the state of decadency. We have actually reversed our gear. We were losing our identity. We were getting enmeshed in the globalized forces, but again we are tightening the sense of identity. Now, why this default? Now, why the other parties, they have not been able to do that well? Now, when it comes to all the identities that I have talked till now, the identity of religion, the identity of caste, the identity of class, the identity of language, the identity of region. Now, out of all these identities, the most important identity is the identity of religion. Now, we have certain political parties who are playing their card on the basis of caste. That is the BSP, we have the SP, and we have RJD. We have these kind of secondary parties who are playing their cards on the basis of caste. They are less based on religion, but when it comes to the potential out of all these identities, it's the religion that can give the political parties the maximum benefit, that can give the political parties the maximum number of votes. So the fight that is currently going on, because when it comes to religion, it is less manageable in identity. You can manipulate with the caste. You can always say, yes, we are with the poor, plus we are supporting the Hindu. We are with the Dalits, plus we are supporting the Hindu. This is the stand of the BJP. Now, when it comes to the Chaturvarna structure of the Indian societies, we have the Brahmanas, the Kshatriyas, the Vaishyas, and the Shudras. Now, in the initial days, BJP was focusing only on the Brahmanas. And then they begin to realize that by just focusing on the Brahmanas, the Hindu Brahmanas, they will not be able to put up a face. Then they had begun to focus on the Vaishya community. Now, this Vaishya community is basically a business community. Now, they have created their own setup of field among this class, among this group. Now, BJP is actually an amalgamation of Brahmanism, Brahmanical class, a subset of the Kshatriyan class, and a subset of the Vaishya class. And they are now trying to exploit this class. Plus, all this is done under the envelope of religion. Now, why this ascent is bad? This ascent is bad for India because if we will sustain this ascent, then we will not be able to have the true transformation of India. Now, what the BJP has done in these 2 years? They have actually added envelopes to the various policies that were run by the UPA government. They have actually just tinkered with the policies. They have not come out with any substantive changes in the policies. Digital India was existing before the BJP came into power. Swachh Bharat Abhiyan was existing before the BJP came into power. They've just changed the name of the policies. The urban policies, they were in existence before the BJP came to power. So every policy, they have actually just tinkered with the policies. Now what they have tried to create, they have just tried to create iconography for themselves. Iconography in the form of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, iconography in the form of Shyama Prasad Mukherjee, iconography in the form of Deen Dayal Upadhyay. They have actually just tried to exploit the name of these personalities for their own benefit. Now, why it's not good for a country like India? It is not good because in this way, we will not be able to come out with the progressive policies. So the panacea, the solution lies in de-identifying ourselves, not getting clogged to the identities, be that the religion identity, the caste identity, the class identity, or any kind of identity. Any kind of identity, it introduces fundamentalism, it introduces adamancy, it introduces stiffness, it introduces unchangeableness, and that is something that is not required for our nation. This was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. You can contact me at 8454-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes and entire civil services preparation. In order to avail the information of the classes, please visit brainyias.com. In case you like this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. So this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.